To our panel members and to our research advisor, Dr. Jojo M. Villamin, good day. We are the Group 8. For today's major academic practice, we will present our research paper entitled Evaluating the Effectiveness of E-Learning on Hospitality Skills.
Introduction. In today's highly competitive market, hospitality graduates faces numerous obstacles in finding work. To remain a successful player in the industry's competitive game, a company needs to hire a skilled workforce. E-learning is an alternative way for the hospitality student. Background of the study. Hospitality e-learning education enhances students' positive learning experience and promotes their growth and development through knowledge increase, discussion, and independent learning. Further, hospitality e-learning broadens students' horizon, and this can aid their future hospitality careers. Significance of study. The finding of this study on evaluating the effectiveness of e-learning on hospitality skills would be beneficial to the following: hospitality students, hospitality industry, hospitality management professor, and future researchers. For this study, we'll be able to give a helpful information and data to serve as a guide and reference to corresponding studies about the effectiveness of e-learning on hospitality skills.
In this figure, the researchers found in Salmon's IDEA activities, the institution can relate this design to e-learning mode to help the student find their preferred mode of learning. The idea is to help the student explore their abilities in online learning. The 3P model explained the proper process of adapting to the online mode of learning that would help the student adopt the different types of teaching. Because learning is the progress of processing the context into action and performing the final output.
Based on the chart of conceptual framework, the goal of this conceptual framework is to assist both student and teacher in gaining a better understanding of hospitality course team and expanding their horizon in terms of e-learning opportunities.
Statement of the problem. This study aims to evaluate the effectiveness of e-learning on hospitality skills during of the COVID-19 crisis. The following statement of the problem was formulated about demographic profile. What is the level of effectiveness of e-learning theoretical output on hospitality skills at Polytechnic University of the Philippines? And what is the level of effectiveness of e-learning laboratory output on the hospitality skills at Polytechnic University of the Philippines? Hypothesis. There is no significant difference on the level of effectiveness of e-learning on hospitality skills in demographic profile, theoretical output, and laboratory output on hospitality skills at the Polytechnic University of the Philippines. Scope and limitation of the study. The study aims to evaluate the effectiveness of e-learning on hospitality skills. The study will be limited to first, second, and third year students. It will be conducted between April 2021, and there will be 450 respondents that are currently enrolled in Polytechnic University of the Philippines under the College of Tourism, Hospitality, and Transportation Management. PUP, the College of Tourism, Hospitality, and Transportation Management is a vital arm of Polytechnic University of the Philippines. Hospitality skills. It was further observed that hospitality and tourism education in the universities in Nigeria is in confusion as to which faculty the program should be run. 10 of the universities was attached under the Faculty of Administration, 8 was under the Faculty of Agriculture, and the remaining 3 universities placed it under the Faculty of Social Science and Management Studies. Self-paced. Online instructors should consider developing their online readings, videos, or links to material discussing importance of self-paced and how to succeed in online college coursework. Communication based on e-learning. As the threat of pandemic has forced online courses, research on e-learning should focus answering how online communication should benefit the main stakeholders of education at the academic level, lecturers, and students.
Learning content. E-learning has become a popular term in the age of information and communication technology with various interpretation and perception. Feedback. It has the ability to effectively speed up the teaching and learning process. Monitoring. One of the solutions for completing teaching learning process while the school is still closed is to use the Google Classroom. Conversation. The concept of e-learning could be a technology-mediated learning approach of great potential from the learning academic.
to action based on e-learning. Alvarez et al. 2016, for computer science student, computer programming skills may be regarded essential competence, and numerous attempts must be made to provide supportive learning packages with evaluating capabilities. For Veronica Racheveda Mo, 2018, digital technology have a significant impact on educational philosophy and practice. As a result, a variety of remote learning options have emerged. For collaboration based on e-learning, for CARE et al. 2018, today's educational concept student should be grow up to be a person with 21st century abilities, critical thinking, and problem-solving abilities.
Application. According to Al-Azuwei and Parsler 2017, to facilitate the learning process, educational institutions all over the world have implemented various learning innovations, such as learning management system. Synthesis. The similarities is e-learning adopted in the Philippines. The shift to online classes because of the pandemic. The difference is e-learning structure in a different college and university. They have different types of online platform like Zoom, Google Meet, and Edmodo, and in the module as well. The justification of the study is blended learning. The teacher have a different style of teaching, the asynchronous and asynchronous. Asynchronous is happen at the same time, and asynchronous is doesn't happen at the same time.
The research design. The researchers used descriptive quantitative survey for this study. It is a quantitative method which emphasizes on the use of objective measurement, statistical, mathematical, or numerical analysis of data collected through polls, questionnaires, and surveys.
Population and sampling. The study focuses on the effectiveness of e-learning of hospitality skills on the academic performance of CTHTM of PUP. The population of our respondents are in total of 450. The researcher sources of information are from the PUP Santa Mesa taking BSHM, BSTM, and BSTRM. The researcher used stratified sampling. Researchers use this method because of its speed, cost-effectiveness, and ease of availability of the sample. To understand better about the population, the researcher will need only a sample, not the entire population. 450 respondents currently enrolled at PUP. The study will be limited at first-year, second-year, third-year students at CTHTM of PUP.
Instrument and validation. For part 1 is the demographic profile, and for part 2, is the level of effectiveness on effectiveness of e-learning theoretical output on hospitality skill at Polytechnic University of the Philippines. For part 3 is the level of effectiveness of e-learning theoretical output on hospitality skills at Polytechnic University of the Philippines. For Likert scale, highly effective, not effective.
Result of Kornbach alpha is equal to 0.951.
Validated with 3 evaluators. The result of validation was questionnaire approved.
Data gathering. A quantitative technique was chosen as the research strategy for this research. For the purposes of this research, we are conducting survey using a questionnaire through a Google form. As far as data collection tools are concerned, researchers prefer multiple sources to gather data, which is conducted using email and social media. Data analysis. Researchers use inferential statistics that use a random sample of data taken from a population to describe and make inferences about the population. According to Manitab 2018, inferential statistics are valuable when examination of each member of an entire population is not convenient or possible.
Thank you for your kind attention to our presentation. We are now ready to your inquiries and suggestions.